Hey everyone, welcome to another edition of Learn to Live Stream with Miss Ileane. My name is Ileane Smith, and in this video, I want to show you how you can go live on Twitch without using OBS. You don't have to worry about that learning curve. You can use one of my favorite live streaming tools called Streamyard. But I want you to stay to the end because I also have another alternative. Now, there's two important things that you need in order to live stream on Twitch. The first thing you're going to need is a stream key. A stream key, it's just a string of characters. So don't worry about it. It's not really techie. You just need to know what button to push in order to grab your stream key. Go to your Twitch channel page and then add to the end of the URL /dashboard/settings. That's all there is. Now that link is going to take you to the back end of your Twitch settings. And you'll see here the stream key. You're just going to copy that stream key. You can put it in a notepad or some text document on your computer, but don't let anyone else see it. Now, the next thing you're going to need is your Twitch server URL. And I also created another handy link for you to grab your server URL, ileane.link/Twitch servers. When you go to the Twitch servers page, you'll see the recommended servers up at the top. Those are the ones that are physically located near you. So around the world, there's all different servers. What you're going to need to do is copy the link to your server. See, I have it highlighted here. That's the link. Okay, you got your stream key, you got your server URL. Now let's head over to StreamYard. When you're on StreamYard, you're going to scroll down to the bottom on the left-hand side where it says Add Destinations. RTMP server. This is the current way that we need to connect to Twitch and some other streaming sites like Mixer and so forth. So let's just open that up and you're going to put your server URL in there and you're going to put your stream key in here. So hang on while I do that. Now I've copied and pasted my server URL and of course I hid my stream key. And I gave it a nickname, and you may have more than one Twitch account, so make sure that you name it appropriately. And then you're just going to click Add RTMP Server. Next, you'll just create a broadcast like you normally would on StreamYard, and I've got tons of tutorials to show you how to get started with StreamYard. So let's fill in a title and start our stream. Now you enter your broadcast studio. Make sure that your mic is working and the correct camera is chosen. Now the other way that you can stream to StreamYard and Twitch is using Restream.io. All you have to do is go over there and connect your channel. And in this case, the process is much easier. You just need to authorize your Twitch account with Restream. You don't even have to worry about the stream keys. You go back over to StreamYard and connect Restream and start your live. One last tip for direct streaming to Twitch without OBS is to use the software that I'm using right now to record this video, and that's EcammLive. EcammLive has a direct integration with Twitch, and you notice it's one of the options at the bottom right hand side, right along with Facebook and YouTube and Periscope. you can stream directly to Twitch with EcammLive. So there you have it. There's multiple ways that you can live stream on Twitch without OBS. You can bring on guests. You can do interviews. There's a whole lot of possibilities over on Twitch. You can become an affiliate, and if you get a big enough audience over there, you can become a partner, which will help you make money through Twitch. Make sure that you have your Amazon Prime connected with Twitch Prime for all the extra perks. I've got an entire playlist of Learn to Live Stream videos where I show you how to go live on Twitch, YouTube, Facebook, and so much more. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.